Hi, and welcome to Retro Eric. This episode is once again about the PicoMEM, now in version 0.8, with some brand new features. And since it's been almost 6 months since my last video, I'm gonna just show you all the new features since then. So here we are in the main menu. Nothing much has changed here. The one new thing we can see all the way to the left is version 0.8, and of course the build version is also brand new. Memory section, not many changes in the menus, but there are many improvements regarding memory speed. First, the code for the PSRAM is now using DMA. This makes EMS and using PSRAM for conventional memory about 30% faster. Just to recap, PMRAM is the RAM that is built into the Pico and is therefore faster, and the PSRAM is the 8 MB RAM chip soldered on the ESA card. So with this 30% speed increase on a PC like the IBM 5150, there should be no noticeable speed difference between the PSRAM and PMRAM. Second, Freddy Wii has removed the delay caused by the I/O char ready signal during BIOS ROM access. This means that ROM access is now twice as fast. So with a faster ROM access and DMA for PSRAM, we now have faster disk access. Since BIOS memory access is now twice as fast, disk operations will be slightly quicker. We have reduced latency. Memory read and write operations are now 600 nanoseconds faster, meaning programs that rely on frequent memory access will run more smoothly. We have also better system responsiveness, especially if you're using applications that depends on PSRAM. And in the disk menu, we have not many visual changes, but underneath we have increased the number of hard drives and floppy images you can use from 32 to 128. That should be enough for most users. But even more importantly, you can now access the micro SD on the Pico and a USB memory stick if you connect one to the USB port on the Pico. And this is as easy as loading a driver. So let's take a closer look at that, and let me boot my PC and we'll show you. So it's quite easy. We are using the new developed tool from Freddy Wii called PMDFS. So let's take a look at that. It has a few options, but basically it's as easy as typing S-B-D to install the driver for using the SD card on the Pico. And if you want to use the memory stick that is connected to the USB port, you can add U-E like that, and it says the driver is installed. So if I take a directory listing on drive D now, which is the SD card, you see how extremely fast it is. And now we can also edit files directly from DOS. We don't need to remove the SD card anymore to do changes in the Wi-Fi TXT or the config TXT file. And if we also test the USB memory stick, it's a lot more stuff on that stick, but still it's super fast. This method supports FAT32 and EXTFS and a maximum of 128 gigabyte, even on DOS 3.1. That is not bad. And the reason for this is because that all the emulation is built into software on the PicoMEM. So now we can use even an FAT32 drives with 128 gigabyte in size in MS-DOS. That is not bad at all. And since it's not counting free space, directory listening is almost instant. Okay, let's go back to the PicoMEM setup. Okay, we are back. Talking about USB, Freddy V has also fixed a bug or two regarding the PS2 mouse. So that should be more stable for some of you who had problems. He's also corrected a bug that prevents some IDE disks to boot with the PicoMEM image as the second disk. So let's move over to audio section. Here we have something new. Under the audio section, he has added a new sound card option, the Mindscape. If you've not heard about this, you're not alone. I only heard about this in a YouTube video from Old School PC just a few weeks ago. You should check this video out, link is in the descriptions. Not many programs use the Mindscape sound card, but Freddy V has updated his mod master so it can play the music on the Mindscape sound card. Also, the VGM player can now use the Mindscape. Be aware that the Mindscape can conflict with the network card and XT IDE. And under the other section, we now have a new feature called real-time clock. How great is that? I know many of you, including me, have asked for a real-time clock, and Freddy V has finally created a solution for us. The clock that is emulated in software on the PicoMEM is the AST 6-pack real-time clock chip. So you will need the AST clock tool to set the time. You will find this on the PicoMEM GitHub page. Since the PicoMEM card has no battery, it will not keep track of time when turned off. Except, and this is quite clever, if you leave the USB cable connected to a power source, it will keep the time. Not bad at all. Well, that was all the updates on the PicoMEM in this video. I am monitoring Freddy V's progress on the PicoMEM closely. So press subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out. Thank you for watching.